identity, as I'm deeply embroiled in a plot to infiltrate the Supreme Court in America. Yeah, I've got all sorts of things to pin on all of the presidential candidates, and I do not want you to know my identity at this early stage. Okay, today I'm going to reveal the Dutch mafias. Yeah, and they are really quite scary. Okay, I'm going to get a more informed spokesman to come and talk about that. He may also wear the gods' colours. He's kind of spooked by their power now. Okay, so good morning, everyone. My name is George Lees, and I've discovered some horrible things about popular culture and my favourite songs when I was a youngster. Okay, let me play you that now. It's called Roddy the Rat. But when I was a youngster, and when I got my guitar, this was the first tune I tried to play, because it's sung by Val Dunican, and I loved it then. Okay, so it's Roddy the Rat, and it's about a little windmill in old Amsterdam, where the Royal Dutch fascists still live. Okay, there's the rat. Yeah, and this takes us into the Aryan jokes written by the Grimm brothers, and piping all of the sad rats to war and to their deaths. Okay, so this is Val Dunican that sings the songs about Delaney Roosevelt, yeah, and his donkey, and all of them are in the Masons. Okay, that's Paddy McGinty's goat, Delaney's donkey, and the windmill in old Amsterdam, where the earliest financial frauds were perpetrated. Just a little stanza or two. And then I'll explain the jokes.
A mouse lived in a windmill in old Amsterdam. A windmill with a mouse in, and he wasn't proud. He sang every morning, how lucky I am. Living in a windmill in old Amsterdam. I saw a mouse.
So, yeah, Amsterdam is below water levels most times. When the Dutch royals got into the laundering the cocaine in the Philips light tubes, yeah, it was a massive flood that year. All of that is on my website. All of it has been explained. So that's one of my favourite songs. Okay, and I used to watch cartoons all the time when I was a youngster. Okay, and the man who put his finger in the dike, unfortunately, because of the political correctness issues, a dike is now become something to do with kind of twisted sexuality. So I will not show you the finger gesture for the dike, but all of the jokes are the same jokes as the PISO family launched into the world. Fergie is on the front page of the papers again, looking quite plump, like some of the Rothschilds that we've talked about in recent days. Okay, all of this is the same joke. It's their joke, and it takes us right into North America, which is the music that weird guy was playing at the beginning of the video. Okay, because all of it, the American mafias and all of those tunes about culling the American Indians, it's the same people. And it takes you into Hudson's Bay, and the bay is the bears in the woods. The bears in the woods are the Rothschilds, and the Rothschilds are still the world's owners. Every revolution, every war, even those massive conflicts between the Dutch, the Spanish, the French, yet the Five Flies all over the world, yet then America gets the right to join in when it becomes the land of the free. And that's the launch of the global mafias, and that's what I'm going to expose now. Okay, this is where it started. A leak in the dike. Yeah, the boy's name is really quite funny. Yeah. I forget what it is now. It is tragic that I've forgotten that, because the boy's name is, and this is written by the, not the Mandelson that Hannah Rothschild admires so much, but it's Jack Mendelson, and it's the leak in the Dyke story in Old Amsterdam. Yeah, under the water levels, they've got it all canalised. Yeah, they make the women sit in the windows, and that is the role of women all over the world. Hannah Rothschild, Valerie Jane Lees, and all of the people that join Intel and learn to speak properly like they did in that Hambro era, when the SOE was run by the people that run the Hambro Bank, and that is all wars for profit. Okay? So, Dick Van Dyke is in the Mafias. Yeah, that's the Mary Poppin Mafias, okay? And the name of the boy may come back to me. It's a terrible thing having all of those concussions. Most of the harm done by the English all around the world.
About this little Dutch kid and how he got to be a famous hero. It all started in a place called Holland, which is a light blue country surrounded by water, including on top. This is why the people got away wooden shoes, so they'll float. Also, they have to put up fences called dikes in order to keep out the ocean. That way, when they want some water, they'll just open the door.
Ready?
Holland is also known for its windmills, which they use instead of air conditioning. Also, the people go around in blue pants.
Do you get that one? That's the Walloons that sailed on the Mayflower. It's the air balloon joke, and it is the clog shoes to stay afloat under the weather storms that the gods give us. Let's take a little look backwards and see if we can find the joke. The joke effectively is the B rim, yeah, because that's the water levels, but the name of the boy was Hans Brinker. Right to the brink, he puts his finger in the dike to save that country from the acts of God. Yeah, and it's the cider sea. Yeah, that's the original sin joke for the Christians from that region. Okay, do you get it? The world could not be more evil. YouTube legend of finger in the Dutch folktale. Okay, I will not show you any more. I think that's the gist of it for you. The boy wakes up and he eventually becomes a hero in the country because he saved the country from the act of God. Okay? Right to the B rim, and that's the Grimms are the authors of the Aryan myths. Okay? And when you watch this video all the way through, it's all the smoking jokes about the PISO pipe and his ancestors. Let's take you a little bit further.
Which is how the Flying Dutchman got started. Some other famous Dutch things were Peter
So that's British American tobacco and the suppression of all of the 500 nations across the ditch. Yeah, you can see how massive this is now. I've got very little more of the story to tell beyond these videos that I'm making, but the lists of foundations and corporations that are run from all of the genocidal companies and militias that take over the whole world on the in the name of those five flies. Spain, Holland, Portugal, France, England. Yeah, the navies and the armies to asset strip and to steal the whole world from the people that God planted all over that world so that their genetic traits could give them a lovely, innocent and peaceful life. Even in winters like we're having here, it was snowing this morning when I began to discover this. So do you get it? The name of the boy. Okay?
Manhattan Island off the Indian.
I give you 24 bucks.
Already got 24 bucks.
Isn't it all very, very funny? Watch for the PISO jokes. These guys smoke the pipes. When you look at the name of the tribes' names are also the PISO jokes. Okay? All the way through American history. It's a joke about the white man being the whiteboard, and it's the master race out of Naples, Italy, and then the Frankish nations, and eventually the Flemish fucking coast, where we're talking about here. That's the Dutch fascists right into World War II, and now King Juan Carlos has become a politician in Scotland, because all of them are just actors, and they own the world by deceit and killing. Very popular with Hitler, Rothschild, the Dutch fascists. Yeah, all of it. All of them just roll over and pretend that they die. Yeah, they get to party all through wartime, and all of these people with the bunny ears, yeah, and the feathers from the doves and things, it's all a massive joke.
And last but least, Rembrandt the artist? Anyhow, this little Dutch boy lives in a city called Amsterdam. Actually.
So that's where the ladies sit in the window, Hannah and Valerie Jane. Yeah? Yeah? And there's the water levels. Yeah? That's the way that the world is run now. That could be the Hoyk lottery winner. Okay? It's the same plight that they've put all of themselves in by stealing and killing from the people that they govern.
I changed the name a little, because this is a family show. Anyway, one day his mother sent him on an errand.
Now, Jackie, you take this basket of goodies straight to grandfather's house.
Okay, Mom. So off he went, skipping merrily down the cobblestone street. When all of a sudden he heard a strange noise. It was a leak in the dike. Right away the little boy realized what would happen if the hole got any bigger. The whole Don Amsterdam Don would bust. And entire buildings would get swept away.
Did you get that? I didn't get that till this morning. That's hell with the word PISO behind it. The whole of Christianity is a fraud for profit and launched out of Leiden in Belgium, 2 years after the beginning of the massive 30 years war. That could well be Amsterdam. They've got a saint called Annihila. That's annihilation, and that for the Masons is the aim of the game. Yeah? To render our globe extinct of human beings.
So he decided to march in his own business. But then he thought about all the bad things that could happen too. The whole city would get filled up with water, and people would have to take a bath when it wasn't even Saturday. Somehow the little Dutch boy would have to stop bullying. First he tried by using chewing gum.
Oh wow, the financial bubble has burst. Do you get it? That's the tulips from Amsterdam joke. And the earliest investments in stocks and shares in natural products, which are the flowers in the garden, which is the PISO floors castle joke. Okay? The PISO floors castle joke. Flowers for Brandon Flowers. And all of the jokers that sing all of those songs, okay? Right then. Let's just keep trickling it down.
But that didn't work so good. So next he tried by using his grandfather's pipe.
Pie, piso, pipe. For Harold Wilson in the bombing of the Yemen.
Only that idea was all wet off of. The little boy knew there was only one way to plug up the leak. Now all he had to do was wait for some passerby to pass him by. Pretty soon, along came a bunch of kids on their way home from school.
Yo-ho! Hey, kids! Oh, this way!
Only they didn't hear him on account of their wooden sneakers made too much.
You can do that like the pythons do with coconut shells. All of it is directed to the PISO's favourite horsey joke. You remember the Monty Pythons with the coconut shells? Giddy up, horsey. Same jokes. Every genocide, every profiteering exercise when the bubbles burst. Yeah, like the global economic crisis in 2008. All the same jokes, all the same methodologies, all through world history. And the Springwood Estate in my hometown used to supply the bulbs. And the Springwood Estate in America is the home of FDR, who is Delaney's donkey Roosevelt, Delano Roosevelt. All of it is a joke about genocide and religious treason and lies. That's why they came from Leiden on the Mayflower, and the Little James, and the Fortune, all of them. And I've got the American registrations of all of the clans, the Mafia clans, who went to America. They're still stupid enough to publish it openly. It will take me about 3 videos to get to that stage.
Then suddenly, he noticed the water in the dike was rising. And worst of all, night was falling. It looked like the little hero of Holland was really in Dutch. Meanwhile, back at his house.
That, please notice, is the half moon warmongering joke. I did not know about that till this morning. And when I learned it, the snow stopped and the sun came out. Yeah, it's the Turkish warmongering joke. That is the demonization of everything that is unknown to you in Homeland Security. Okay, and can you see the hints of the American flag beginning to emerge from that story as they head west, young man, to the YMCA? The next bit might be really dangerous in my amateur video making bit because it's copyright infringement. Yeah? It's the Butlins, Born Leisure, Ann Horner joke, and it's Little Jack fucking Horner, and it's the colour purple too. All of them belly laughs for Hollywood.
And all the while, the people of Amsterdam slept peacefully in their nice warm beds, without even knowing why. Then all of a sudden, it was morning. Out in the meadow, a farmer was milking his cow, when he suddenly spied the brave little Dutch boy lying next to the dike. So he pulled out his thumb, and stuck in the plum, and said,
"What a good boy are you!"
Have you heard that one before? Yeah. Kind of like Val Dinigan's output. It becomes familiar to every Mason all across the world. Okay? Let's just go to the end.
The people of Amsterdam were so happy that he saved the city from drowning that they made him a yells and threw flowers and even named a sandwich after him. But best of all, they took him out and got him plastered in Paris and put up his statue as a token of their esteem. And from that day on, the little Dutch boy spent his night at home, where he slept heavily ever after.
So, it's crude and it's rude, yet which is a favourite Dutch name, and that is the finger up, the fanny joke, yeah, for all of them, yeah, and the pie pig jokes is the kissing of the feet, and that's why Fergie's back in the news this week. Okay, and a dyke now is, I cannot describe what a dyke is, because for, yeah, I got that terrible conscience complex. Okay, let me show you some other jokes about the Canadian continent that they conquer. Yeah, and the rat moves elsewhere at the end of that movie with the Freemason and all of the Irish sectarian jokes. Yeah, that they impose on themselves and their own children to keep everybody hating their enemies. Sorry, hating their neighbours against all of Jesus, who never lived, rules. Another cartoon here. Deputy Dog. Yeah, this is about a searched for the character that is in this, and the name of the character that is in this will be apparent in a little bit. This is the launch of all of the religions, and the echo joke. It's about policing, this one. Yeah, Deputy Dog is yeah, part of the inventory of cartoons that explains the royal ownership of all of those vast tracts of land in everybody else's country. Muskie is the name I found when I was looking at the Hudson's Bay Company. Yeah, it's a territory that they took over. It's a foundation that they founded once they had robbed all of the American Indians blind and killed them all. Led now those companies by bakers, and that is the jokes, yeah, about, shared by my favourite Canadian Facebook friend. Okay, so so do you get it? Every Mason, Arthur Hastie, and the guys in the lodge, even my informants, they all understand all of these crazy jokes. They understand entirely that Scotland can never be free, while they're quite happy to sit in the lodge and keep their friends and kill their children in the great conflicts. Yeah, so when he sings it out from the top of the mountain or into the cliff face, yeah, those are the cliffs that the acts of gods create, and the massive waterfalls in Canada, like Churchill Falls, yeah, all the law enforcers do is just chant it back, which is why at this point I'm going to play you this. Yeah, that's Sing to Jehovah, and sing out the message that Jehovah, which was launched by the Rothschilds too, and the Russells, yeah, it's the Canadian Mafia joke too. Okay, guide me, O thy great Redeemer, and see who the beneficiaries of all of it are. you get it? Every religion, just sing it out. Learn the lyrics. Steal and deceive all of the worshippers, and look at the massive money screen you create, provided law enforcement globally just sings it back. Yeah? And Muskie is an icon for the vast tracts of land that the royals still own all over Canada. Okay? And I can show you some images of all of the jokes put together. Fool's gold, okay? This is the story of the little boy from Holland with his finger in the fucking dyke for profiteering reasons, or through the PISO story. That's Brinks Matt Robbie. Okay? And it's fool's gold, and guess what the accent is? Fucking Cockney Michael Caine, more names, Michael Caine, and Michael Caine makes the jokes about the gold bricks and all of the goals about the world leaders through all of world history and every fake religion. Every character I can now explain. Every actor I can now explain. Dick Van Dyke is in it. Yeah, all of the horsey jokes, the little guy that was in the movie, yeah, about the life of Pi and the Pi racehorse with national velvet.
Let's go!
So do you see the template? This is how Ronnie Biggs got to live on the government's money in Brazil. That's not the government's money at all. It's the Rothschilds' money. It's the 13 Illuminati families. And it's quite spooky because it's the 13th of February today. And even the Valentine character is in the Dutch Mafias. Yeah? Like King Juan Carlos and Beatrice's missus. Yeah, all of it is a massive joke. Okay, Mickey McAvoy Bean. Yeah, this was made and uploaded on the 12th of October 2007. 1 year behind the great global crashing of all of the banking stories. And when the Queen met her government for the first time in a meeting with the cabinet that was prompted by me, she asked whether or not the gold in the vaults at the Canadian-owned Bank of England were still doing okay. Okay, I'm going to show you a few more images and then we'll go on to the story of the Dutch Mafia's Dick Van Dyke. Okay, so there's where we start. There's all the actors that we've talked to you about. That is the one that makes all the movies about Jumanji and playing the game. The whole story is a fraud against the people. I forget what the hero in that is, but all of the characters in it, including Pocahontas, are traitors to their country. Yeah, the Roosevelts are in it too, and he's playing in that, an American president, one of the ones who took the bung to liberate Israel. There's the bear in the joke. Yeah, it's the Rothschilds again. There's the Roman armies. That's the Pisos again. Yeah. Every story, every character I can give. When you listen to the Lydia song, Lydia, oh Lydia, oh have you met Lydia? And you look at the tattoos on her body, it's the same jokes about all of it, leading to the Warner Brothers, the Dilla Warrens, and all of the rabbits. Since Lagos of Macedonia, and that is just St. John in the Bible, because it's Iago in Latin. It is in Spanish. St. Iago is St. John, and that's the wee James joke, and all the ships sailing with all the crooks on them, that are the same elite families that still own the world now. Yeah? There's the Pharaohs, that's the Ptolemies in the bloodline after, yeah, Lagos the Rabbit and Alexander the Great. Ecky, ecky, ecky for the pythons. Okay. So, what else? Another night at the museum. I could not get one showing more of the characters. Yeah, there's the twat from England that plays that Ricky Gervais, the man who cannot own himself. Yeah, it's also a joke about the nomenclature and the ownership of the a massive fur trading company that is the USBC. The Canadian fur trading company is a huge part of this story. And it's run by a bear too. Do you get that one? That is Rupert Bear. That is Rupert Murdoch. That is Rupert the Bear for Beaverbrook. The joke about the canals and the beavers creating the lakes and the massive Dulac jokes. And this is the Dutch Van Dyke Mafia. Yeah, totally, totally dedicated to covering up the mafia operations that are actually genocidal operations. When the Germans do that in World War II, they get a terrible guilt burden for it. And all of that is the same policies of all of the Freemasons that I met this week, Arthur Hastie. And the Hasties, the Hastios that do the narcotics laundering in the Phillips light tube jokes, and do the fake murders on the Isle of Wight where Queen Victoria's children, or the only legitimate child, was raised, yet then murdered by the British royals. Yeah, and all of these characters play the Virgin Mary in the Von Tripp family singers jokes and the Genevieve movies, and all of it rolls on and on and on. And he gets to stick his instrument up the chimney, which is another icon for the female organ, yeah, which he saw in the Christian church. Okay, there it is. And this is the genocide by medicine joke. All of the families that are run by these families, I'll get down to the list. It will take me at least 3 videos to expose this. Hannah Rothschild, you're off the hook. I'm still waiting for your phone call. Okay, so here's the Third Reich eugenics. Human sterilization today, the goal of the Dutch mafias as they transit across there with their medicines, yeah, and their spoonful of sugar jokes, yeah, and that's the tree of life. Only the master race are allowed to live. Yeah, and it becomes a Jesus's cross in all of the ruthless jokes. Okay, noise, yeah, that's the Dillanoi joke out of Holland. Volks genocide das il ach dein Geld. Don't know what that means. Okay, and all of it is the joke about the war graves and all of the bones piled up near Basel, where all of the teeth are emptied of the gold. Yeah, and we could go down and we could make it more and more embarrassing for the duchies, yeah, who give in to this lot as they sweep across Europe and they end up at the Channel coast, yeah, until we get the massive battles at Stalingrad when they decide to go in the other direction. That's the biggest tragedy in this story. Yeah, it's the 1.5 million people were killed at Stalingrad, and they then had to quickly change its name. The Rothschilds funded the communist icons. Yeah, you know that now. All of it is the same family's histories. 13 of them, 13th of February today. Yeah, there's many more than 13 of them. You'll see that. I've got a list of it, John Lamont. Yeah, in the Dutch mafias in New York. The icon, yeah, for the people that sailed from the Merchant Adventurer Company from York, the launch of Christianity into the killing of every American tribe. Same companies, I've got their director numbers. It becomes Q fucking Gardens, and when you look that up recently, they're the subjects of the massive floods like the Dutchman. I'm ad-libbing. This is a search for Scottish Borders Freemasons. All of them know these jokes inside out. That's why they call me Sir now. Yeah, one of them will one day be asked to put a knife between my shoulders. Yeah, it's the Freemasonic police. The polis have the word PISO in it. Yeah, it is a massive set of bimbos and dumbos. Yeah, and all of them wear the baldric to celebrate the joke about the Blackadder team. That's the baldric character in the trench scene who says, yeah, isn't it nasty that you can get a splinter in this great conflict off the wooden steps, as all of the innocent people, yeah, who opt out of these organised SSs, yeah, get gunned down in millions. Yeah, Stalingrad is particularly tragic, and I'll show you video clips of that. This video will almost certainly be banned globally. Okay, Queen's House, it's the care homes jokes about the Dutch mafias who go to America and launch personal health care, one for one, yeah, for the super elites. Yeah, if you're on the wrong side of the fence, you cannot afford anything, and everything that was public, yeah, before 1960, Arthur Hastie, is now privatised by the people that live in the Better Off Together region of my town called Broomlands for the Plantagenets, and that includes the doctors that tried to section me and the councillors that run all of the literary profiteering. And there's the Queen's head. Pub, I didn't realise it had a Christian cross on the other side. All the same joke as the Windsor Shire, as they get their guidance from the faked up Jehovahs who were launched by the Rothschilds and the Russells, who were the school headmasters when I was a boy, and it's begun to snow again. Isn't that poetic? Yeah, that's the Stalingrad story. 1.5 million in a conflict run between people who were trained in Tavistock in Britain. That's also the horsey joke. Yeah, that's Stalin demonised by FDR, and all of the people called the Douglases that run the estates called the Springwoods, yeah, they know all of the jokes already. Okay, and Queen's House is the name of the care home now, privatised. The woman in it is relatively decent. She knows I'm a good man, and she comes and meets me. She collapsed in the church in the early days of my investigations. Like several of the doctors, yeah, from the Cumbrian crime scene. Okay, and there's the Royal Dutch Shell logo for the fraudsters in Holland. And with my earliest lobbying, I get to the football clubs, because they've got massive followings, and most of their supporters are spoon-fed with the sectarian stuff that I told you about in the last video, about Rangers and the village people and the only gay in town being a Rangers fan. Yeah, that's the Staten Islands jokes about the village people. It's the village island, and that is the we are the people joke for the Rangers. All of it, the sectarian Dutch prostitutes joke for little James. Are you getting the magnitude of it? No one in politics works for the people or for their country. They work for a laugh in the sleaziest jokes and the most fatal jokes that the world has ever known. I don't think we're even going to get onto the one note evidence for all of this. Okay, so that's what you get. For Philips is the company set up by the Dutch royals. They ran the cocaine in those Philips light tubes. When the receipt of the stash was confirmed in the crashing planes and the missing planes saga, Field McConnell, and the no nottings from Abel Danger. Yeah, many of them are biblical jokes. The joke about leather from hides is a joke about Job in the Bible, and I learned it yesterday, and the sun came pouring out. And look at the tragic consequences of today's news. Can you see the snowfall? Yeah? It's absolutely amazing. That's the Dutch royals that run that, okay? That's the cocaine in the Prince Philip's light tubes, because Prince Philip and the triumvirate with Onassis in the 13 elite mafia families run the narcotics, and the coppers are obligated not to do anything about it, and the pressmen get killed if they tell the truth. Rupert Murdoch, Rupert the Bear, in charge of the Bears, yeah, which is the Rothschilds, in the massive company that is the fur traders in the Bay, yeah, and that's the Bay City Rollers, and that's the Bay City where Madonna was born. Yeah, there's very little else to tell once I get through these videos. So there is FDR, his family run the heroin all around the world. They spark the Chinese opium wars when you're allowed to trade narcotics in America without any breach of the law. There's the Fala Murray jokes of the dog that was owned by Roosevelt, who started World War II, who bombed Pearl Harbor with his elite group of friends, and all of the orders come from her lovely family, not this generation. Yeah? All wars, all sides, all massacres, all missions, every one of them is entirely for profit. And that's the Clouseau jokes about the pink panzer divisions that started the genocides in Treblinka for the Warner Brothers. Okay, Masons in the monarchy. All of them are led in Britain when I'm a boy by that twat that presents the prizes at the Wimbledon tournament. Yeah, and all of it is for profit. That's the Dow Jones icons, and there's all the Rothschilds and the symbolism and allegiance to the Freemasons swastika all across the world. Yeah, the heroin years for the American presidents. There's Dick Cheney of Bedfordshire. Yeah, also Rothschild territory. Okay, Elena Hilaria Fitz Utrecht de Morville, the Murrayvilles. Yeah, all of them are the bloodlines that take you back to Lagos. And there's the British American Stuyvesant Dutch joke. Yeah, the tobacco. All the agents that are around me now, I see them smoking the fags. Yeah, none of them have the courage to talk. Yeah, only the crippled Masons start to talk. Yeah. Right then, what else have we got? Yeah, the Hudson's Bay Company. Yeah, the Bay City Rollers. The Bears. The Bears in the Wood. Teddy Robinson for my wife and my children every Christmas. Yeah, and you can see it a little bit closer. A little bit closer. Yeah, and that's the elk and all the jokes I was told about by the Rice family. Birmingham and the Icknield Way is the Rice jokes, all of it shared by the Freemasons, and all roads lead back to Rome, where the PISOs started it. Yeah, do you get the bear joke now, Miss Valerie Jane Lees, as if you did not understand what you're laughing at, the great genocides? And when I made that statement in the court the other day, yeah, there were not even any tears from you. That was the statement that I made to Sheriff Peter Patterson, who comes into the story later on, because the Pattersons with one T are the heads of the Bank of fucking England. Yeah, it's the Bank of fucking England that is now headed by the Canadian on that massive salary. And all of the lands that are up for grabs here still belong to the Brits. That's the Geordie joke about the Freemason line and the people from the Northumberland region, like Perseus, the Percies in the Roman court, are scamming everybody already. And that's the Harry Potter joke. Right then, so just a few more images and then we go, and there's Yosemite, all of it, vast tracts of land, and the Churchill Falls are right in the middle of the crime scene, and all of the people are revere the history, and it's quite stunning that they're quite prepared to publish it still, but the foundations try and cover it up. It's really easy to see through them. Yeah, that takes you into the Norton security firms and the Masons of Birmingham and all of the people that run Birmingham City Hospital and the people that try and get me sectioned in my hometown who live in the same street as me and work in Lord Sainsbury's supermarket. Okay, there's the bears of the Red Shield joke. Yeah, and there it is. Yeah, the American banknotes, the rabbit symbols for Winston Churchill, or the great genocides. Okay, and we're getting near, yeah, and there it is, all the jokes of the Pythons against religious worshippers. Oh, but how many of the religious worshippers appreciate it? Yeah, almost every family name I now know is part of the Mafias. And it's tragic that none of them who scold their children for doing something wrong now, you're not allowed to smack them, yeah, but all of them understand all these jokes. And it takes us into, yeah, Frank Sinatra, and it takes us into Dean Martin and their sexual deviancy and their control and mind control of innocent women who get enslaved by these massive fascist methods is astounding. When I went to Jedburgh Sheriff Court on Friday and was told that I no longer am able to make the decision about the sale of my house, yeah, and I'm not going to waste any more of my time on any of their stuff, but I am going to do the hunger strike stuff when push comes to shove, yeah, and I'm going to tell every visitor to this house the truth about the things that have been covered up by our government and our medias, yeah, and I will not allow them to take it from me. Yeah, they're going to have to murder me or jail me first. Okay, I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. All of them in the tax havens, John Cleese, and all of the jokes about Basil Fawlty and all the genocides and all the Nazi gold being taken from the teeth. Okay, and when you put Rothschild's red and the Salvation Army red together with Rothschild's yellow, you get Dutch orange, don't you? Yeah, you've heard the Nell Gwynn stories, the Snowy Cameron, that's Mrs. David Cameron's missus who lost the child, because all of them are cheating the world. Yeah, out of Chipping Norton, where my wife's family come from. And all of them have the Springer Spaniel biblical frauds joke, and the Springers are also in the way over 13 mafia families, and that's Bruce Springsteen's joke. So what do you not know now? Yeah, and there's the Salvation Army, totally created by the Rothschilds. Keep marching on so that we can pretend that we did not launch communism with the Red Shield and all of the deaths at Stalingrad, which is now called St. Petersburg. Yeah, and that's the religious joke that takes you back to the PISO pipe and the little piggies and all of the nursery rhymes that you're now learning again with a new context. Okay, doing the most good. Yeah, They're doing okay, like all of those lumberjack jokes. Okay, let's get on to the other computer. Okay? And it's now beginning to abate, the snowstorm. Yeah? Stalingrad, everything is at the hands of God in the end. God has to stop the great conflicts, because no human could tolerate the weather there or at the end of the Crimean genocides. So I won't be much longer than a minute or two. And the naming, and the jokes about the naming of the Hudson's Bay Company. It's the H. Hudson's Bay Company is HBC. HSBC is David Cameron's other scam, run by his dad in Hong Kong, where Lord Patton was on the crime scene as the Governor General for ages and ages and ages, and came back on the totally immune from prosecution royal family yacht with Prince Charles. So, the Van Din bloodline. Yeah, I didn't pay much attention to it at first because I thought, oh, that might be Dick Van Dyke, but I've never heard of them before, John Lennon. Okay. And please, please, make a safe transition. Yeah, the transition across the Atlantic is quite lethal for everybody involved, unless you're poor already, and then it's really, really genocidal. Okay, so this gives you some summary. So the Van Din bloodline. This is my words now, not the author of this article, who gives us the clues but no pictures. I've added pictures all the way through it. Right then, how do we get that full screen? We had this problem the other day. Oh. And that is the joke about the half moon, die half moon. It's another one of the ships, and I've got the list of passengers on it. It's quite shocking, John Lamont. He's actually quite a nice guy. He's a very weak guy. Yeah, he will not stand up to anything. I saw him lobbying. He now makes radio programs with 8-year-old kids, because that's the only thing he can be accountable for. Yeah, all of the lies. Henry Hudson and the 400 Foundation. Explore New York Dutch history using a unique opportunity in collaboration with Google Maps. Those are the people that made the joke about Noah and the Garden of Eden. Do you remember that? Okay, so let me get it full screen and then I'll start again. Snowing again. Yeah, the Noah stuff, it's really quite offensive to the gods. You never get a mention. And the half moon is the Turkish moon, yeah, that starts all the wars. World War One, up in that beautiful view, that blue Danube region. Okay. And I don't know what I've done wrong with it. It's still not filling full screen. Let's see if we can make it go full page view. Okay, it's still quite wasteful. So let's go to 125, 150. Okay, so that's good. It's snowing gently now. Let's get started. It's going to take ages, but I want you to know that this is where I started, and it takes you to trivial diversions like Dick Van Dyke. Yet when you see him ancient in the museum film, you realise it's part of the New World Order joke, and the American Museum is a joke about everybody else's artefacts being fucking taken from where they were created by God. And that's the Elgin marbles joke for the Archbishop of Canterbury. He's got little models of them in his home where he used to live in County Durham when he was the Bishop of Durham. Okay, once again I've opened up my files of research and tried to investigate the satanic hierarchy. Sometimes in doing investigation one turns down a dead end. That's 1.5 million at St. Petersburg alone. The conflict started by Churchill, yeah, who's the father of Bill Clinton and the father of our current Queen. Yeah, trained the other genocidal leaders at St. Petersburg, at Tavistock. Yeah, that is both Stalin and Hitler Rothschild. Both of them are Rothschild bloodlines. I hope I haven't done that. There seems to be a strong Dutch connection to the Illuminati, and the Van Dyn family might be one of the keys to understanding that Dutch connection. Delanoy, Delano's donkey, yeah, Roosevelt, World War II genocide, 50 million in that case, Mrs. Valerie Jane Lees, who works for these teams and has our children in that massive debt pool. Right then, we can only look at highlighted stuff. In 1626, and this was in the cartoon you just saw, Peter Minuit traded some trinkets to the Canarsie Indians. It's the Canary Indians, by the way, for the fascist laundering out of Odessa. Yeah, all of it is derivatized. And it's the Chiano jokes, yeah? And the Aryan master race all through world history to purchase Manhattan Island. Yeah, that is the joke about the woman with the torch. Yeah? And that is all that's left after the Freemasons have their way in the Planet of the Ape movie. Okay? Canary. Do you see it? Yeah, all of it purchased for $24. And the value of all of that to see the capitalist fascist opportunities that is New York, which is the joke about the York people that are the adventurer company that sails with the Mayflower in league with the Freemasons, and we see it further down between the Dutch Masons and the Scottish Freemasons that took man to the moon. Okay, Manhattan Island flooded. This is the Strauss-Kahn conviction, yeah, for rape, not for the massive IMF, massive financial crimes of the IMF in stealing even from Nelson Mandela's country, yeah, and in stealing from Lech Wałęsa's revolutionary Poland. All of the revolutionaries are on the Rothschilds' payroll, okay? So the gods hate all of that, and when Strauss-Kahn is acquitted for rape, they have a massive earthquake and biblical floods right over Manhattan Island that only cost $24, because the American Indians cannot cheat and steal and kill, but they scalp their victims, yeah, so that Vladimir Rothschild can look relatively innocent in all those jokes about the acid stripping as they go east as well. Massive biblical floods. Manhattan Island was almost underwater the whole of that weekend. Okay, and there is no fault line in Manhattan. Yeah, so that was the beginning of the new Dutch colony of New Netherlands and its new capital, New Amsterdam, built beside Fort Amsterdam, which kills the Indians already. And the people on the Mayflower are the people that train them to shoot and kill the Indians. That's the religious pilgrims on behalf of the PISOs. All three later renamed New York, and that's the York Adventurers Company for the Pilgrim Fathers. That's the business registers still. It's snowing quite heavily again now. Okay, but I've got to get a move on. The Van Dyn family, also spelt Van Dyn, yeah, was one of the Dutch families to come over to the Dutch colony of New Netherlands, which is connected to Dutch West India. Yeah, the Pirates of the Caribbean, and that's the Van Cleef. Okay, from the Netherlands include Van Cees, Van Cleef, yeah. And I can't remember what the Jumanji character is with the khaki gear on that shoots at the innocents in the supermarket. Yeah, there's the cloven hoof joke, and that's Anne of Cleves in Henry VIII's Lover's List. I think she was powerful enough to survive. And that's her. Okay, the Tudors, Henry VIII. I think four of the six wives copped it. And that's the cop Liverpool joke and the law enforcement belly laugh. It's now snowing quite heavily. Van Koorn, Van de Water, Van Duren, yeah, Stutthof, in 1649, 15 years, that's 29 years, yeah, after the Mayflower sailed and just after their massive genocide in the 30 Years' War. 1620, the ship sailed, yeah. And this is the British took New Netherlands from the Dutch, and there's the Gervais jokes coming in and the Connie Nielsen jokes. Van Dyn immigrated with his older sister from Brabant, Netherlands. Brabant is a district so of Eindhoven, where they have a lovely football team. Yeah, and I used to lobby Ajax all the time in southern Netherlands. But at the time Van Dyn came over, it included Belgium. To New Amsterdam, so that's the Belgians, the Walloons joke. Do you get that one about the little boy with his finger in the Piso dike? Okay, it's snowing quite heavily now. Lovely, lovely way that you can communicate with the gods, and I'm ever so grateful to them for allowing me to know all of these secrets. And every time I uncover something, they can confirm or deny. Okay? So that's the Belgians and the Dutch and the Walloons and the Leiden people. Do you get it? The lying den that is the Lowlands. They know that it's going to come over their fence, and they need shoes that can keep them afloat. Okay, the National Cyclopedia states that he came over in 1640. That's 20 years after. So this is another Van Dyn, Dutch Gerrit Cornelianson Van Dyn, immigrating with his sister from Brabant in the Netherlands. For some reason, Gerrit Cornelius Van Dyn returned to Holland to Zwol on the east side of the Cider Sea. Where's my apple gone? Oh, there it is. Yeah. The gods gave me a message to unravel that Melrose School icon from around my neck yesterday. Yeah. Like the pythons. Gerrit Cornelius Van Dyn returned to Holland to Zwol on the east side of Zuider Zee, although he had originally lived in Newkirk in Zeeland. Yeah? Everything is a pistake. You heard the pistakes about the New Zealand Holofernes joke and the Judaism. Yeah? That's the Semitic joke. It's all through this story. Gerrit C. Van Dyn was a coarse, non-spiritual, ignorant man, Ian Paisley, who did carpenter's work. His lack of interest in Christianity. Oh no. I'm I'm not going to start talking about any of this until we got to where we were on the last. Yeah, it's a long, long story to tell. Yeah, some of those pictures may make your hair stand on end. That was the Stalingrad. Oh, no, I'm not going to talk about it. Yeah, that's my local priesthood. And the seminary in Argyll, which is now rack and ruin. Not going to talk about any of it. That was the Göttingen Seven. That was the Queen and Prince Philip, the murderer, head of MI6, head of the Navy, head of the drug running, head of the triumvirate with an Onassis. And there's Bill Clinton and his sister. Now, just a minute. That's the neighbour next door who is a horsey person, has a horrible blood disease, but she still lets her dog shit on my lawn every day. Okay. And okay, there's the Van Dins and the Dutch people that are involved in those massive conflicts under Cromwell the Freemason. There's Stuyvesant. Yeah, and there's the British American tobacco joke for Bill Clinton and the spunk on Hillary's little blue dress. Oh no, we're getting into the storytelling. I'm gonna. There's. Oh no. Sheriff John Patterson. Okay, two T's this time. Quite easy to fake that one up, isn't it? Born 1655, was the evil genius behind the establishment of the Bank of England. Yeah, that's the Waterloo joke and all of the Rothschilds' triumphs. So, where were we? Oh, these are my friends in the news medias for the Fox Empire. There's the Costellos. And we were just on Anne of Cleves. Okay, can you see how much we've got to cover? So that's one of Henry VIII's surviving women, because she's a powerful Dutch woman. And you can see the colours, all the same story. Okay, Van de Water Duren and Dutch Gerrit Cornelissen, yet we're just below that as they transit into America. He came over in 1660, yeah, this is it. His lack of interest in Christianity seems to have cut. Let's take it there, just in case we hit the wrong bit again. Okay, so this is from New Utrecht, and that is Greenwich Village, and that is Utrecht of Cumbria. Yeah, the elite families in that Windsor-Piso bloodline from the Roman emperors, from the Egyptian pharaohs into Cumbria. Yeah, and it's the Greenwich Village, and that's Greenwich University, which was Thames Poly, where Baroness Blackstone refused twice to give me a job because I'm not insightful enough to see through her frauds at that time. Yeah, right then, down we go. Okay, Isabella of Angoulême. Okay, so I now believe that is where Greenwich Village is, and we've got those links to Utrecht. Right underneath, Edward I, married to Margaret of France and Eleanor of Castile. That's all the jokes about the Gallipoli massacres. That's Matilda. There's Elizabeth, Fergus Lord of Galloway, Utrecht of Galloway, married to the Dunbar, which is the region where Archbishop O'Brien lives. And one of my neighbours is at war with the O'Briens, yeah, and he has been sectioned too. Okay, and he's been sectioned by one of the doctors that was involved in my sectioning. Thank you for your courageous phone calls. Every one of them is tapped by Chipping Norton. who my wife works for. Okay? So, there we've got the Utrecht in the Dutch mafias. Yeah? In long run, his descendants, some related to the Costello family. Have you heard of Bud and Abbot? Yeah? Everything is a cover for the horrible truth about who the mafias are globally. And these are the people that sing the Run Rabbit Run songs. Yeah? Make the comedies about not being able to add up. And here we've got five branches in one in Queens. That's the five fucking angels joke for the mafias run by the Costellos in New York. That's the Frank Pentangeli. Penta is five. Okay? Five mafia angels families in Queens, in Kings, in Duchesses, and in Somerset and Morris. And that is the two Ronnie's joke about the Somersets and leaning against the gate with the straw in their mouth. And the Morris name is associated with the Kelso surgery and the sectioning attempts, but he's the relatively decent one. And we have my earliest car was a Morris. So there's the mafia family. That's the five angel mafias in New York. And this is the five that I correspond with through all of my time as a political lobbyist. Dana Perino, one of my one true loves, is in it. She has a spaniel, a Springer spaniel joke. All of them. She used to be President George W. Bush's private secretary in the White House. She stammers a lot. She is very, very weak under pressure, and that's why I love her so much, because all of the people that are picked to be tyrannical world leaders, yet are picked for their power and the gift of the gab. That's Bob Beckles, who's dangerously plump now. He was George Poppy Bush's presidential private secretary, and they are the five angels in fucking New York now. And I spent all of my time communicating with them. They work for Fox News, and that is the Basil Brush, Basil Fawlty jokes that I've just told you about. Okay? Every one of my emails went to all of the news agencies all around the world, owned and run by Hannah Rothschild and her family. Yeah, and there's a Brett Beer who works for Fox News, and they used to share that joke with me all the time. That's Brett Rothschild Beer, Teddy Robinson for my disloyal wife. And all of my children are thousands of pounds in debt already. It's become the expected sacrifice for every parent in our dismembered country. The five, two of whom were presidential private secretaries, Perino and Bob Beckles, which is a town near Ipswich, and Sandringham, and that is Michael Grade's crime scene, and Dr. Stephen Andrew Hancock's OBE's business registers until I get onto him and he shifts them. Yeah, that's the great Yarmouth joke for Dickens and Little Emily and the drowning of all of the innocent people in the massive storms, yeah, that are created by the gods because of these frauds. I've become quite poetic, Lady Jane Grosvenor. When you return to Roxburgh Castle, might you give me a job as the county poet? Okay. And the client, so here's the Cosa Nostra families, and these are the five angels. Do you get it? Gambino, Lucchesi, Genovese, Bonanno, yeah, and that's the PISO. Yeah, that is the husband of Madonna's joke. Yeah. And there's the last one, is the Columbia jokes, the fifth columnists that are the Masons all around the world. Yeah, and they pretend that they have the power to put people in the cornerstones. In the old days, yeah, when we had the semblance of a free press, they actually did that, as they massacred people who stood against them on behalf of their country and the democratic future. Okay? Yeah, and that's Lucky Luciano and all of the killing of all of the returning troops in World War II. Monte Cassino. Okay, there they are. New York's cities, five families. That's with the launch of the news agency for Fox News, run by Rupert Murdoch, with the name Rupert, for the takeover of all of the Hudson Bay Company, Rupert's Country. Isn't it exciting? And it's still snowing quite consistently. Here we've got Frank Pentangeli. There he is, bleeding himself to death in the bath, as he's obligated to do as an ancient ritual, because he knows there's no point in escaping from the feds. Yeah, and that is, yeah, the man that I always saw as my dad's favourite man. Forget what his name is, but my dad had a business partner, and he just reminds me of him. He's organised and businesslike, and when I reported the massive war crimes through the British Legion, he got the head of the British Legion to come and visit. He did not send him to me. Yeah, and his name is a legend in the French revolutionary sector. It's the Dumases. Dumbass. Know nothings. Everything is a fucking joke for them. And you can laugh at the angels, because you can laugh at God too, but that has now become really dangerous since I started making my exposures. And there he is in the bath. That's the one that got the body double in, and that is truly the story about the body double for Martin Bormann in World War II at the Nuremberg trials. In Germany, to use the title Vaughan was a special noble privilege. Okay? Yeah? All of the commanders in chief. It's beautiful, the snow now. The flakes have gotten bigger. Yeah? All of it is the same joke about the world's genocides. I believe the same applied. Yeah, you get special noble privileges, Dick Van Dyke. Yeah, he's the most innocent man in this story. I don't think Bob Beckles killed anybody with a piece of number 8 wire. Okay, yeah, they tried to execute Frank Pentangeli in the pub. The extremely low profile of the Vandens makes one wonder if they could really be one of the top 13 mafia families. Still, Mona Vanden. Can you see?